What's up, everybody? This is Cody, and welcome back to another episode of Cody Plays Minecraft. If you might see and notice, we are in my creative testing world. And what I've done here is kind of spruced up the build that we had done in the last episode of Cody Plays Minecraft here, or our little single-player world, as it were. Don't pay attention to that over there. That is something I've been kind of testing. As a matter of fact, we will take a look at it, but I want to do something with you guys here on camera and just get some, maybe, some advice or what you guys may think would look better. And I can already tell I've already done something that I did not want to do. See, yes, that. I want to bring that all the way up. So, is that not the fantastic thing about having a creative flat world here? So yes, I went with spruce fences for the windows, right? Okay, but there's a gap there. I really like that gap because it kind of gives the window more character, so to speak. And I went with some sandstone stairs or whatever, and went with the spruce stairs or fences for the balcony up here. And I use this because, you know, most sandy cities, I just caught that, they have, let's make sure I got that over on this side. Yes, they have like little awnings here like that. At least that's the way I would picture it anyways, right? So I want to kind of do something with maybe like a circular build here. And let's just do this really quick with us on camera here. And I'll show you some of the things I have been working on. And maybe some ideas that I have for maybe to... Maybe a... 2, 3. You know what? We could just use this right here. What was I fixing to say? I don't remember what I was going to say. Oh, yeah. For the server plans. That's what I was trying to say to you guys. Okay, so we just come back across here. And then we could take... See, let's just type in a fence, and we'll take the spruce fence here. And so this will have to be the sandstone brick, and like so, okay? And then here we'll just wrap around, and like I said, this is a circular build type thing that I want to look at with you guys here on camera while I was here in the creative world, just doing some testing. And today is going to be obviously a little bit of a different episode, seeing that we're here in the creative world, but I don't have a whole lot really planned. So yeah, that's the reason why we're here. I just kind of wanted to get a little something out for you guys. And I just figured, why could we not just come in here and just, you know, maybe you guys can get a first-hand look of how I actually do my builds here in Minecraft. And, yeah, I mean, I don't think most people usually do this type of stuff. Yeah, see, I was afraid of that. And I know why it did it, too. See, what we really need to do here is we just need to bring that out. And then what we could do... We could actually make this more of a, let's just go door. Who's texting my phone? Nobody's texting my phone. And let's just go with the spruce door. I know that's kind of, I don't know, would you call it cliche? I'm really not sure that you would call it that. And let's just, like so, replace this as well. Okay. Let me finish this up and I'll be right back with you guys on camera. Alright guys, sorry about that, clearing my throat like that. Okay, so here's an issue that we have, okay? So to get up this staircase, one, we lose the connecting fence right here. But what do you think with the fence actually not connected here? And it actually gives us, I swear to God, gives us a little bit more room to actually work with, right? Yes, it does. And as a matter of fact, I actually brought this up, I think. Yeah, that's one too high. So what I would actually have to do. So, okay, it ain't such a bad thing to be dealt with. So let's just take this out real quick and we'll just, woohoo. Just do this right here while we're on camera. Or maybe not. Hold on. All right. I have lowered the fence. Or not fence, but what I did is I actually took the sandstone bricks here up one more block. And then I just put the windows or the slabs here at this level here. So what we need to do to make sure this gets to the right height is install that bad boy just like that. And no, that's exactly not what we want. As a matter of fact, I could just do it just like this. And here, yes, we should be able to, but here's the thing. And you know what? We don't have to have an upstairs here, but I think it would be really cool if we try to. Okay, see, look, nice and tight, nice tight quarters, and let's get it back daytime. But I really, what I need to know from you guys is, do we really need this connected fence here, or can we leave it like this? And if we leave it like this, what things could we use? Could we put torches up here? And this is my idea. And here's the thing. I don't know that I'm going to put a wall around this city. And we could. But we could use this type of building like this. Okay? Like so. And this is it. Let's just get a good fly around. We could use this type of building as maybe like an entrance piece, and then we could have like one gate. So this would be one side of the gate, and we could do another one, or we could just do two small versions. You know what I mean? See, here we got it going four out. We could go to three, and then we could just go, I guess what we'd have to do is take this down to one side pillar here, and then repeat the process over and over. So, or let's just see if this will actually work. I haven't even tried this out. No, it's not going to work. So if we did that, this is actually what it would look like. But we will get our connected textures here. And some people might be a little crazy about it. I don't know, man. It, to me, it's different. It's something that I haven't really seen in Minecraft. And hey, I could be just totally off my freaking rocker here. But let me show you some future projects that I'm working on. And we'll just go there, because do you see how many freaking iron golems we have here? We have 33. Okay. And this is a design that I think I'm using kind of off of DocM77. But I'm doing my own little twist around it, okay? See, in 1.8, they were up, villages took a big overhaul, okay? So now you have different kinds of trades. Well, I don't know if it's really different kinds of trades, but the trades, they work differently now. Breeding is entirely different. And that could be the biggest and only main thing that really changed, but I'm not 100% sure. I haven't looked into it yet that much. But I took his design and expanded on it. And basically what I want to do is I want to have doors wrapping all around here. And I want to have farms on either what I would like to call breeding pod. I'm going to call these breeding pods. And the door is going to extend all the way around. And I've just been experimenting with this. And I've been manually feeding these guys to get them to breed. And it has worked. And as you can tell, I mean, we already have, I don't know, we already have 33 iron golems down there, and If I'm not mistaken, I think one will spawn every 6 minutes. Don't take that to the bank just in case I'm wrong. If I'm wrong, just correct me in the comments. Don't be so hateful about it. This is a build that I'm working on, and I'm really not sold on with this roof design. And I kind of need you guys' help because I wanted it to be a little more pointy. You see how this slant or this slope is gradual right here? What I want it to do is kind of come up and then get steeper, okay? And I guess what I could do, and I tried it over here, and God almighty, did I epic fail the crap out of this dang thing. It just didn't work out for me too well at all. Hold on 1 second. All right, yes. So, we're going to leave that at that, and we're going to go jump back over to our single-player world and go check out some of these builds and then talk about some other plans that we could be doing here in the future. All right, guys? All right. All right, guys. We're back here in our single-player world, and this is the monstrosity that we were left with. Obviously, the one in the creative world, in my personal opinion, is a lot better. But I want to see and wait until I get your guys' opinion as to what we need to do out here. And once we do that, we will move forward with this project. And so, yeah, let's move on to something else. Maybe we should go back over to the fishing village. We haven't been over there in a while. And just leave this new area alone and just kind of let, I don't know, maybe the creative juices get to flowing here in my brain or whatever. And then come back to this another time. And, yeah. What do you sell? I need, ooh, what is that? Ooh, a Fortune 3 book. What? How many diamonds is that? I don't think that's actually that bad. What do you do? I need to come back over here and do some trading with these guys before they all die or whatever. But anyways, I'll be back. All right, everybody. This is probably a few days later from the last clip, if I'm not mistaken. But anyways, I had a very, very busy weekend. So anyways, let's just pick up where we left off. Today, what I did off camera is I did a lot of this path area here. I think what we did last time was just down this road to this point here. And I have on sounds. Last night, I played on the multiplayer server that we have. And I played on there with Kevin for probably about 2 hours, I would say. But anyways, I did this weekend. I completed everything down to this point, and I went down here. Okay. And I'm not ready to let these guys out as of yet, and I went down through there as well. But I have some wall plan changes that I really wanted to, you know, just kind of go by you guys with. And are you ready for to are you ready to see what I did and what I'm thinking about just changing everything up to? Okay, ready? You can't see nothing. Ooh, trees have grown. I've actually been out in this area for a little bit of time now. Okay, this is what we have going on. So I really wanted to have some towers along this along this wall, right? Okay, this right here was the original height of the wall, so I increased the height by 2. And what I wanted to ask you guys is, should we leave the stone walls like that up there, or should we cap it off with half slabs? Now, I'm not opposed to either one, but here's something I wanted to run by you guys as well. I don't really care about that. Let's take this, and I don't know why I have those there. Okay, let's go over to this workbench And I'm sure all these will get used anyway. So let's just, what I want to do is see, is would it look better if we did like little viewing windows with regular stone brick, or should we do it with cobblestone? And what we could do is do that little viewing area about every, if we did it, we skip one, so we go, and we did one, so we go 1, 2, 3. Should we do it like this? Or, and here again, let's just do this one. Let's do this one right here. Thank you. Let's do this one with all stone brick, and let's just change this one to cobblestone stairs. Let's just see what it looks like. And I've got some plans to come in here and like texture this wall up a little bit, but if by adding in the dark oak wood and the stone brick, it actually gives it a little bit of texture anyways. So the question I have to you guys, should we do the viewing windows? How far apart? Should it be cobblestone stairs or or brick stairs? I think the brick stair looks a little bit better just because of the simple fact that we have a lot of cobblestone in this wall build already. So let's just come back and do that like so. And hey dog, you need to get up inside. He's the only one that's gotten out, and I'm not exactly sure how he's gotten out either. But anyways, I think for the most part, he's pretty safe. I just need to go around this entire fenced in or walled in area and just kind of go back through and make sure all the areas are lit as much as possible. So yes, okay. So here, stone brick. I think the stone brick stairs looked better. But should we do the spacing on the walls? Because if I'm not mistaken, I don't think I can shoot through this. Oh, I can shoot through this. But mobs can't see me through this, I don't think. Somebody else can correct me if I'm wrong. And here, I just, you know, just a little something I whipped up real quick. And, you know, I put a little bit of texture into it. Didn't put a whole lot of time. I think I did this in like, I don't know, 10, 20 minutes, maybe max. And this could easily go up another height. And instead of having these stairs here or ladders, we can make a little staircase. But I'm not entirely sure. Is the height fine? Okay. Yeah, I thought this was a little cool little thing. You know, if we ever got invaded. Although, see, this is, I need to stop treating this like this as some kind of cool thing. And I don't know, dude. We may end up, because if this is the fishing village, right? Maybe we just turn this thing into an entire kingdom and just maybe spruce up these houses a little bit and build some other things in here. Because, well, believe it or not, this area, I guess, is kind of large, isn't it? Okay. Let's see, how should I do this? Yeah, I thought that was going to do that. I'll tell you what, let's just walk over this area. See, ouch. This area is a very, very large area indeed. And what I was originally planning to do is maybe we can make this a window. What word am I looking for again? God almighty. What's that thingamajig over there? I do like that wall a lot better, more than just this plain cobblestone wall. Cobblestone wall? Cobblestone? Oh, almost. Oop, over. Oh, crap, I suck. Good God, this boat sucks. Shut up. In the face, son. tower. Let's just call it a freaking tower, man. I don't even know what the heck I'm saying. But anyways, this area goes way out this way. And we'll run over there. Let's just do it real quick then. Yeah, boy, get messed up, man. They some baddies over here. Oh yeah, dude. No, shh. Not even gonna worry about it. Not even gonna make me mad. Tell you what, we're out of here. But anyways, you see how big this area is. And we could even do like a huge watchtower over there. And dude, I got some killer ideas. Okay, there it is. Let's just go ahead and just go back to what we, I think what we're actually going to work on today, because. You know what? Oh God, dude. Freaking frame job for real. Let me make sure my brightness is all the way up, and it is. And I should have saved some ender pearls. Okay. Dang it, man. Do I not have any? I sure don't. But that's fine. That is quite fine. So, what I want to do today, with that villager purifier that we did, I don't know how many episodes ago that was. I know it was a few, but I'm just not sure exactly how many it was. What I want to do is... Hey, little fellow. How you doing? How you doing? Anyways, we need to get this area right here cleaned up as well. We really need to start doing some work down in the... down here in the Nether Hub. We need to get this thing set up. We have not gotten the thing set up, and it's absolutely a freaking eyesore. We also got some work we got to do up in the Nether ceiling. We need to get a proper elevator up there instead of using that ladder. There's so much work to do in this world that we haven't even finished. We have so many freaking unfinished projects that it's not even funny. The interior of the butcher and bakery is not done. The storage house is completely done. The blacksmith is done. We've got issues here that we need to resolve. Huh? We've got an area for the... for our people to die in. And we've got that area finished now. So that's what... 2 projects done. Holy crap. So we're working on the fishing village. We just started another project over at the Lost Sand City. We've started that project and I'll be right back, guys. Alright, guys. What's up? I had a crash there. Not sure why. But anyways, I'm just going to start this back over. And we'll just go from the top, I guess. So hopefully everything will work just fine. Okay. So this is the top. And pretty much what we're going to have to do is build a building to make everything just kind of look good and symmetrical here. And like I said before, but somehow or another it messed up on me. What we need to do is I'm sorry, I just lost my train of thought. No, I'm going to briefly explain how this thing works, this elevator, and hopefully this thing will work right. I've tested it out off camera the other day, actually, and this thing should work. So no. Crap on a cracker. Okay. We're not going to worry about these fools. They ain't going to mess with us. So, this is what you do. You hop in a minecart, just like so, press the button, and dropped. Alright, now if all works out well, what we should have to do, or only have to do, is press this button. I swear to God. And the freaking button. Where the... There goes the button. Why? I had this thing working, literally. Ah. Aha! Yes! Aha! Just like so! Yeehaw, boys! Let's do it again. Let's do it again. Let's see. Uh-huh. Fall down? To our death? Ah! All right. Very, very nice. And... back up again. Oh, sweet boy. Dude, yes, sir. We're going to do it again. We'll do something to pretty this little area up right here for sure. And, yeah. We will do something to pretty this area up. And I think the next time, or the next episode, I'll probably have all this done off camera. Or that might be our episode, really, is to prettify this area. So, let's see. Nope. You're nobody I really care about. And is there anybody? Okay, so we have a librarian. And earlier, we got this guy. And he actually turned into a weaponsmith. So, very, very nice. Very, very nice. So, maybe, yes. Maybe next episode we will try to get this thing. So much quicker than a freaking ladder, guys. So much. Did an Enderman pick this up? I bet he did. Freaking Enderman. Stupid idiot. Alright, guys. I think that's going to do it for today's episode. Once again. Oh, I tell you what. No, we did not look at this. We did not look at this. But you need to check out Woolly Creeper. Okay? You need to check out Woolly Creeper and his tutorial for this elevator. Because he's the one that designed this thing and came up with this contraption here, and it just teleported me back here. So what you need: sticky pistons and movable objects with the sticky pistons, the button here to launch it. You need that minecart because it will not work properly without it, to my knowledge. Okay, but the start of it is you put this down. You know what, I think that's supposed to be a piece of redstone dust. It works either way. But anyways, your first repeater goes that way at 2 ticks. And then you go up 4 blocks here, 3 blocks here, and 4 blocks here. And then you have this tower. And let's see if we just can't get up there real quick so I'll show you. See this torch tower here. Uh-huh. So the torch down there, inverted torch, that torch, I meant piece of redstone dust, and then you get your two immovable furnaces is what I use, and then another torch tower, and then your slime block launcher is right there in the front, and see right there. Okay, but the next repeater, this next repeater here, faces this way at 3 ticks, and then you from there you can go up 6 different, repeat this thing right here 6 different times at repeaters facing this way at 2 ticks. Okay, but like I said, I'm butchering what he how he did in a tutorial, so check out his tutorial, guys, and until next time, peace. Alright, sorry about that. So where did I leave off? Yes, we have done nothing. I literally went brain dead when I was sitting here trying to design this thing off camera. And this is our, this is going to be our main building for our nether hub, or nether building to the nether hub. And I've went completely brain dead on any kind of design. And I wanted to build out this way a little bit, but I'm really not sure what to build. And I'm going to wait until, because see, I'm going to wait until I do something with this entire area, because this entire area here is going to be changing really soon. And I'm just not exactly, ooh, I need that. Not exactly sure what I'm going to do right this minute. I do have some ideas, but like I said, I haven't got them completely hammered out. I really haven't decided on what design I'm wanting to do with this as of yet. But, okay, on to what I think I want to do for the rest of this episode. We have this zombie purifier down here, right? Yeah, boy. Where did I come out at up here? I think it is... Dude, I got everybody and their freaking grandma coming after me. Get away from me. Is this where I come now? Holy crap, I'll die. Yeah, I think this is good right here. So I think this is the entrance that I actually have as of right now for the zombie purifier. And or villager purifier, thank you. Just get off of me. And I have plans for this. Come on, come on. This is our librarian, and we need to name him, and we need to start working back on that library project, which, once again, I'm not exactly sure what to do. But I'm going to get to work on this bad boy off camera and get some things set up and collected, and I'll be back with you.